Hello, today I have one more corona case study for you. A 15-year-old diabetic person, policeman, was tested positive for corona-19 infection. He had high fever, chest pain and shortness of breath. Upon arrival to emergency OPD, he was tested for his oxygen level by pulse oximeter and the reading was 87%. Which was significantly low. Normal range is 95 to 100%. Hence, his arterial blood was sent to laboratory for blood pH, oxygen, carbon dioxide and bicarbonate levels, and the report was as follows. Well, from the report on the left hand side, one can understand that blood pH was decreased, indicating acidosis. Carbon dioxide was increased. Oxygen level was decreased. Standard bicarbonate was increased. And his serum ferritin level, however, was increased significantly. This is a typical case of respiratory acidosis, because level of oxygen is low and that of carbon dioxide is high, and increased blood bicarbonate appears to be due to compensatory action by kidneys to absorb and retain more bicarbonate during urine formation, and plasma ferritin levels usually increase in severe microbial infections. In this case, increased levels of plasma ferritin indicate severe viral infection leading to pneumonia. And the reason for high level of carbon dioxide and low oxygen is due to accumulation of fluid in the lungs caused by cytokine storm caused by corona-19 infection. Refer to the figure on the left hand side. In the case of normal individual, during pulmonary circulation, oxygen tension in alveolar air is 107 and that in venous blood is 40. And this difference, pressure difference of 67, drives oxygen from alveoli into blood. Similarly, carbon dioxide tension in alveoli air is 36 and that in venous blood is 46. This difference of 10 mm drives carbon dioxide from blood into alveolar air. This way, blood gets purified and gets sufficient oxygen for systemic blood circulation. Due to fluid accumulation, this normal gas exchange is seriously affected, and alveoli are not able to exchange these gases, and that is the reason why patients are seen gasping for air, means for oxygen. Now let us discuss the biochemical events of cytokine storm. Macrophages get activated by increased ferritin concentration as the viral infection spreads in the lungs. When activated, macrophages begin to secrete specific protein molecules known as cytokines. These are signaling molecules that mediate and regulate immunity. These are responsible for further activation of macrophages, helper T cells, mast cells, B lymphocytes and eosinophils. At low concentrations, cytokines are safe for the body and help to protect it against viruses and bacteria. At high levels, however, the so-called cytokine storm develops, which can be lethal for half of the patients, especially for the elderly. Viruses typically attack the respiratory epithelial cells, which trigger a cytokine response. Pattern recognition receptors of the immune cells recognize the virus and signal release of various pro-inflammatory cytokines, and these cytokines are interferon gamma, tumor necrosis factors, interleukins, and various chemokines. In the body, a protective inflammatory response is created by release of prostanoids. This leads to redness, warmth, swelling, and pain at the site of infection due to increased blood flow. This increases blood capillary permeability that leads to accumulation of fluids in the tissue spaces, and this event causes breathing difficulty as I have explained earlier. Now I will explain you the principle of oximeter. When oximeter is placed on a finger and when it is on, red and infrared lights pass through the finger and through arterial blood which contains oxygenated blood and venous blood which contains deoxygenated blood. Oximeter contains one red light emitting diode and one infrared light emitting diode. Oxygenated blood absorbs more infrared light and deoxygenated blood absorbs more red light. Ratio of 1:2 is correlated with saturation of oxygen value by a built-in processor, and this correlates very well according to Beer and Lambert's law. For more information, kindly refer to our textbooks which are available on Amazon.in and also on www.bhalani.com. I thank you all once again for your grand support to our books and also our YouTube channel. Kindly share our free videos with all your friends and subscribe them. Live safe life, take great care of yourself, and have a great educational phase. Next time, I will get one more video for you.